In the last video, we worked out the theory of simultaneous diagonalization in the case that one of the matrices was non-degenerate, that is to say, when one of the matrices had all of its eigenvalues with multiplicity 1. Now we're going to tackle the general case. So the theorem we're going to prove is that if you have two diagonalizable matrices, or two diagonalizable operators, and they commute, then they're simultaneously diagonalizable. Now, the first step is to show how B acts on the eigenspaces of A. So let's suppose that E lambda is an eigenspace of A corresponding to the eigenvalue lambda. Then I claim that if V is in that eigenspace, then so is BV. In other words, B maps the lambda eigenspace to itself. This is always assuming they commute. Okay, so here's the proof. So we know that BV is lambda V, and we that AV is lambda V, and we want to ask what is A times BV. Well, that's AB times V, and that's BA times V, and A times V is lambda V, and you pull the lambda out in front, and you get lambda times BV. So BV is also an eigenvector with eigenvalue lambda. That's our lemma. Okay, now armed with that lemma, here is the proof of the theorem. So first, we're going to pick a basis that diagonalizes A. Now, some of the eigenvalues of A might be repeated. You might have lambda 1 a bunch of times, and then lambda 2 a bunch of times, and all the way out to, let's call it lambda k. That's fine, and we've just shown that B in that basis, since it sends all of these vectors to linear combinations of themselves, that gives you a block up here, and it sends all the things in this eigenspace to itself, gives you a block here. So it makes B into a block diagonal matrix. And then we diagonalize each block. And if you diagonalize a block, that gives you an eigenvector of this whole matrix. You take the eigenvector of B1 and you pad it with zeros. Or the eigenvector of B2 and you pad it above with zeros and below with zeros. So, now, the eigenvectors of the block are also eigenvectors of this block, because this block is just lambda times the identity. Everything is an eigenvector of the identity. So now we've got vectors that are eigenvectors of this block and this block, eigenvectors of this block and this block, eigenvectors of this block and this block. And they correspond to eigenvectors of both A and B. And we're done. Now, that may have gone by a bit fast, so let's go over this in the case of a specific example and see how it works. So here are two matrices. They're both diagonalizable, and they commute. If you multiply them in either order, you get this matrix. Don't believe me? Work it out yourself. So we want to find a set of vectors that are eigenvectors of both A and B. The first step is to diagonalize A. And diagonalizing A isn't hard because A is a block matrix. We diagonalize this corner, we diagonalize this corner. And what we discover is that there are two eigenvalues, 2 and lambda 2, and that each one has multiplicity 2. You get an eigenvector 2, 1 from the upper left corner and 0, 0, 2, 1 from the lower right corner. Likewise, for eigenvalue negative 2, you get 2 minus 1 from the upper left, 2 minus 1 from the lower right. So here are our four eigenvectors of A, two of them with eigenvalue 2, two of them with eigenvalue negative 2. And I'm calling these bases the D bases because I'm saving the letter B for our final answer. Okay? In other words, A in the D basis is block diagonal. Lambda 1, lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 2. The next step is we need to figure out what is B in that basis. So we compute. We compute what is B times D1. You multiply the matrix B times D1, and you discover that you get D2. Well, it has to be something in that a linear combination of D1 and D2, because it has to be an eigenvector of A with eigenvalue 2, and it turns out to be exactly D2. Likewise, B multiplied by D2 gives you exactly D1. B times D3 gives you D4. B times D4 gives you D3. So that means that the matrix of B in the D basis takes this form, which again, it's blocks. So this is our block B1. This is our block B2. And it corresponds to this twice the identity and minus twice the identity. Okay. So the next step is to diagonalize each block. The upper left block was just 0, 1, 1, 0. Well, we know what the eigenvalues of that are. It's 1 and minus 1. The eigenvectors are 1, 1, and 1, minus 1. And the lower right block happened to look exactly the same, coincidentally. So, same answer. Great. Now we can diagonalize the whole matrix B in the D basis. If you have the eigenvectors of this corner, you pad it with zeros in the bottom, and you get an eigenvector of the whole matrix. If you have an eigenvector of this corner, you pad it with zeros at the top, and you get an eigenvector of the whole matrix. Remember our tricks of the trade, block diagonal matrices. So here we go. We take the first two eigenvectors, pad them with zeros. Second two eigenvectors, pad them at the top with zeros. So now we've got our four eigenvectors of B in the D basis, with eigenvalues 1 and minus 1, and 1 and minus 1. Okay. Now we want to convert back. We want to say, hey, 1, 1, 0, 0 in the D basis really means 1 times D1 plus 1 times D2. That's 2, 1, 2, 1. 1, negative 1 in the D basis means D1 minus D2. 2, 1, negative 2, negative 1. 0, 0, 1, 1 in the D basis means B3 plus B4. D3 plus D4, this means D3 minus D4. So these correspond to the original vectors, this, 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 and this. And I claim that we're now done, that these are eigenvectors of A and they're eigenvectors of B. They're eigenvectors of A with eigenvalue 2, 2, negative 2, and negative 2. They're eigenvectors of B with eigenvalues 1, negative 1, 1, and negative 1. Now, you want to check. So, in other words, A and B in the B basis take these forms. And if you want to check, you just multiply it out. You know, A times B1, here was A, here's B1. You multiply it out, and sure enough, it's twice B1. B times B1, you multiply it out, it's just B1. So B1 really is an eigenvector of A and an eigenvector of B. And you can check for B2, B3, and B4.